Alright, I'm back. A little bit of a break from this, which is admittedly one of the nicer areas of the game. I just need to make sure that I wasn't waking up my housemate, who's currently taking a nap. I was getting a bit annoyed at this. Oh my god, my eyes. Those characters are more interesting than this one. Yep, your eyes are up here.
And what about the...
No.
And what about the Big Bang by physicists?
Every living being in the universe is subjected to periods of sleep and wakefulness. Also, the universe itself got such periods. The current universe is one of many in an infinite series that got no beginning and no end. The universe is eternal as a whole, and it got periods expanding and collapsing.
Does it breathe?
It breathes. The breathing out is the manifested life of uncountable worlds. The breathing in is the sleep, the temporal ceasing of visual life. Everything in the universe is built on analogy.
Yes, let's be honest.
The sage proclaimed, "The luxury is haunting me. When will I repay all the debts?"
Yes, we're ultimately screwed as a species. Even if we get off of Earth, the universe will die out, the sun will burn out, the... maybe collapse in on itself once it all starts fading. So unless we can jump between realities and back and forth, yeah, we're a bit boned. Admittedly, I like the disco ball. Don't usually see them multicoloured like that, but that would be leaving multicoloured, you know, things all over the floor.
Now, many people have surpassed the narrow-headed ones from the past. Terms of filth, lies, murders, betrayals, sophistication in doing mean things to each other, etc.
But there is one significant difference. Whatever the narrow-minded people of these days do, they do it with full responsibility.
How's that?
Every conscious being produces a responsive action to any of its own actions, including even the most evanescent one. This is the cause and the consequence. It's called karma in the East. The responsive action can be either a beneficial one or the opposite. It depends on the behavior of the creature who produced it, i.e. the cause. The consequence is whoever is whining about, "What did I get my suffering for?" In this case, he must ask, "What for?" himself in the first place.
God's punishment.
Okay.
This is unbelievable
screwed.
Rubbish.
Please explain.
God is not a grandpa with a beard. God is a ever-present principle.
A principle?
Yes, the principle. The planets orbit the stars according to it. The laws of physics, chemistry, biology, mathematics. I.e., everything that men awkwardly found in form of science is the essence of the principle. It is also the golden ratio principle, the Pi number, the Planck's constant, the speed of light, the length, the width, the height of space, and so on and so forth to infinity. A seed lying in the ground brings forth a spring according to this principle. According to the same principle, the seed creeps up and becomes a blossoming beautiful rose. This is the principle according to which a man knows he's in love once he looked at somebody's eyes.
Well, that's convenient. Science is our religious principle. Or part of it.
And what about the DNA of this growing seed?
The seed's DNA is a material manifestation of the principle.
Right now, it is perceived differently, in vain.
The servants of human churches personified this principle. They turned it into the idea of the creator of heaven and earth. By downplaying it to a God-man, such a God got already a certain character. He gets angry, he blesses, he punishes, but he can be easily appeased, especially if one brings gifts to his servants. In actuality, only the man is the master of his destiny, living in a universe that is based on the principle. One must ask none but himself, why he or she is so unhappy.
How did that
One cannot escape his destiny.
Destiny is laid with human hands. One should say that. One cannot escape himself.
You make your bed, you lie in it, right?
Correct. We reap what we sow. And likewise, all ancient sayings talk about karma or destiny. Call it whatever you want. Karma is like scales that are always trying to balance what's been given against what's been received. Such a balancing act can be redistributed from one reincarnation to the other.
Oh, you can't have your cake and eat it here. You're either, hey, man's his own destiny and all that lot, or you're going karma, reincarnation, and spiritualism. You can't have both. So get stuffed. It's absolute nonsense. It was like, huh, you've kind of gone more, you know, flipped round. And it's like, oh, no, karma works with it. You can't say there's no destiny and have karma. Indeed, if you act in a fashion that is good to others around you, you're more likely to receive good things in return. But you're just as likely to be exploited by really evil goits. And there's sometimes you simply, no matter what you do, can avoid a horrible things. Because crap things just happen to good people due to chance and just extenuating circumstance and the maleficness of others. That doesn't say you shouldn't be nice to others. You should.
A rake is an agricultural tool for raking and loosening the soil.
Yes, that is the definition of a rake. How does that apply here? If it wasn't for the computer, I'd say we're in a softcore porn set. I really wish they had more female models for this. I'm so sick of looking at her. Oh. Hello, gentlemen. Okay. Fair enough. I am of no use to you. More TVs, more dancing.
And what happens next?
Until that conscious being understands with its heart that that's not what is allowed to be done, according to the ever-present principle of harmony, growth, and beauty, until it will get hit with a rap on the forehead from its own actions, until that conscious being understands all of this, it can't break through from the reel of samsara, of reincarnations, which purpose is the same, to train him to be a human.
It is hard to imagine what awaits everybody who is consciously doing evil on Earth.
There's no need to imagine. Everyone gets exactly what they deserve at the proper time. Every human is his own destroyer and helper.
Oh, get screwed. So I deserve to have cancer twice.
Why are there so many heavily sick on Earth?
Shut her up. Yeah, it's like, why is there starving children in horrible places?
Random events, 124.
If, it's like the old saying is, if there is a god, he's either evil or incompetent. And if he's incompetent, why bother worshipping him?
Look around. Look at nature. Everything is so harmonically built in the universe. Every atom is in its place. This manifests in everything from the sun to a firefly crawling in the grass.
Garbage.
Random events? This is simply illogical.
Dices. I'm throwing the dices. It's a number rolled at random, isn't it?
No. There are hundreds or even thousands of conditions. The throwing power, the height, the angle of rotation of the dice, air resistance as a function of the angle, and so on and so forth. a distinct sequence of conditions. The same applies to a cup with coffee spilled on the floor, or even stumbling on the street. There's no such thing as randomness in nature. What I'm trying
this
to
probability.
Say is that it doesn't exist at all.
Perhaps.
Look wider and deeper. Every event in your life is not random. They're not random. They are a cause and an effect.
Let's go back to the cup with coffee. Did hand slip?
A human is a very complex system. It has the deepest and a multi-million intertwinings. A flow of liquids, nerve impulses, chemicals, electrostatic charges. And these are physical categories only. And energies? They are thoughts, moods, wishes, etc. The same huge number of external, visible and invisible impacts, sensible and not, instant and temporal. If only one could embrace all this complexity. Some rough thought is sent in space, abruptly and carelessly. A definite answer comes back. It may return as a cup with coffee spilled on your legs. Or perhaps it comes back as joyful news. It all depends on the power and the colour of initial dispatch from the source to which it returns.
Garbage. Just because everything is potentially cause and effect does not negate randomness, because the cause and effect can be influenced by certain factors, which can be influenced by certain factors, which can be influenced by certain factors, which then brings probability into it all. Just because, you know, cause and effect is a thing does not mean there is intelligent design. Yeah, let's get the hell out of here. Hell, I'm not even atheist. I'm pretty much agnostic, bordering on atheist, because I just go, screw it.
There's a song called There's No Way Out.
Yes. I essentially say screw it. If I'm judged at the end of my life, I'll be judged. But if not, then, well, I'm forever in darkness and not coming back. You know, I'm not going to be paid or anything, so, eh. Eh, it's depressing, but at the same time, not really. It's like the whole idea of uploading your consciousness. Technically, your original's still going to die, so you're still going to be dead. There'll just be a version of you bouncing around. It's not, well, it is you, but it's not you, you. You're making a copy of yourself. May that copy may continue, but you are still gone. There is no immortality. Unless you're a Highlander. In that case, you better be good at hanging around on holy ground and putting up with the horrible, horrible sensations, because otherwise someone's going to try and murder you. There can only be one! Yeah. My pimp dealer is back again. WeTube or Universe Connect. Zeppelin Airlines. Cheesy cheese! Made of milk for your breakfast. Oh, I wish I could have some cheesy cheese. Or any cheese. Well, the migraine repercussions. Okay, back to the pimp.
Fine, it didn't work out with the monkey. But look how this God principle cheated you. In actuality, it does not exist for you since it is just a principle. You are an orphan in the universe. Some are praying to strange gods. Others are melting toilet bowls from gold. The third ones cut each other's throats. The fourth ones, the fifth ones. And you? You either swim here on your own or join whoever you like.
There are others. They are moving forward. You are wrong about that it's all left to chance. Also, there are those who guide. They got those who cannot settle the golden toilet stool or meaningless existence.
Is that so?
Yes, there's the next stage after the human stage, superhuman. It is the beings from this higher stage who help us. To be precise, it helps those who don't deny the helping hands.
Point me in that direction, then.
Deeply logical.
Do they hear people's prayers? Do you think they are so all-powerful?
When looking at the development gap between humans and previous stages, yes, one can conclude positively about the power of the superhuman stage. Eureka.
It demands evidence but presents none.
What?
A hierarchy of beings in space without the end. Superiors help subordinates.
But why?
You need to bring your fever down with water. I've lost.
Absolute nonsense. Absolute nonsense. There is no example. And you could say the superhuman would just be God then. He's gone in circles. In fact, one moment. Save. I don't know where this is saved. It's bound to be a file that lingers on my computer. Ooh. No. Oh, God. How about this way, then? Okay. Oh, no, I can't go up these. Where the hell am I supposed to go? Or is the only one who's waiting for the song to end? Be nice if there was some kind of resistance helping us out, but sadly, probably not the case. This is just bringing out the cynic in me. Oh, it teleported me back. I can't go past that car. This is just terrible design. I'm forever trapped. Oh, he's vanished after that. Yep, it's just another listen to the song until it's done. It's like, oh look, you've beat there in the sky.
This bone is mine.
I mean, the environments are really quite fun to look at. The models, not so great. At least no more nose ring. Oh. You can't even wipe that. Interesting tattoo marking or something on her leg, even though it's a jumpsuit. I just keep looking at these environments and feeling like this is wasted on this. Oh, Christ. Oh. Is that erosion and wear and tear? The old sci-fi random numbers of gibberish. Yes, it looks very futuristic, but ultimately all meaningless. God, I'm definitely getting an Aliens vibe.
Dear Keeper Lady, could you be so kind and tell me who is this dealer psychic who has constantly encountered me during my journey?
Prince of the Earth.
The Prince of the Earth?
Yes, this is Devil.
You seem pretty calm about it.
An enemy is half defeated after he's been identified.
Yes, but he does not exist.
His greatest achievement is that he managed to insert that thought into a human. Thus, he is able to act in a more subtle way.
There's no god, but there's a devil. Oh, fuck's sake. Yes, the old quote.
Who is he? What is his essence?
Once upon a time, young humanity was assisted in development with several superior beings, and he was one of them. One had to bear a huge power of the heart to stay away from any temptations and pride. Due to primitive man's imperfection, Devil failed to stay on the high level. He got jealous. He began a harmful fight against those he came with. This is how his ultimate downfall happened. He is a traitor.
So this is the origin of evil in the universe.
No, this is not exact. And it is wrong. The Prince of the Earth can tempt a human with the tricky means, trying to bind him to the Earth and suppress the development. But the human acts himself. Deliberate evil is not the law of cosmos. It's a local and temporal phenomenon.
Will it be over?
It will be over. Another question is who remains, and who will be thrown away, left for painful corruption as space junk. Been a lot of commotion. There is almost no time left to repent.
There appear many cults on Earth, liars of all kind, robbers of the soul and the body and all that. How can one avoid their traps? How to discern their lies?
The leader of such gatherings always deems a fee. These prophets with checkbooks, loud chiefs during lavish parties.
Well, yeah, if a religion starts demanding money and objects off you, then they're usually up to no good.
Strange human-like beings depicted on objects found in different places on the Earth. There are hundreds of these findings, as well as pictures and even cave drawings. And besides, they are by different nations from all over the world. Sometimes such beings are referred to as nothing short of gods.
Correct. A primitive man perceived them like that. Young humanity really saw them as gods, because of their comprehensive knowledge. And you have already guessed who they were.
Why do they allow that all sorts of disasters happen on Earth?
Cosmos is not an iron cage. A man got free will. A man can choose. He moves at will towards creation, mutual aid, helping others, kindness and love. Or the man becomes Hitler himself by devastatingly falling into excruciating corruption. Another thing is that without the direction, the whole of humanity would have failed, not just once. Plato, Confucius, Buddha, Joan of Arc.
Doesn't belong in that list.
Akbar, Saint Sergius of Radonezh.
Is the superhuman state susceptible to the influence of karma the same way we are?
No.
Joan of Arc does not belong on that list. She was used as a flaming puppet by the king and then disposed of by the very French that she helped save. And what would have been the overall negatives of England actually taking over France of that period? It's hardly world-shattering. I mean, it could have been interesting historically, but overall, this is really large, actually. It's not really a thing that would have had too much of a lasting effect. Certainly the British Empire would be a bit more powerful. Crumbs, I'm lost. Well, bugger. I'm expecting a friggin' facehugger. It's like, run! But there's something usable down here I've just not noticed. Because there's so many glowing things. And as much as I like the environment, a lot of it is copy-paste. I mean, that's pretty pretty. But yeah, it is all repetitive. It's the same assets used over and over. Yeah, I can't talk to her again. Okay. So it has to be that way then. That's just something around here I just didn't see or has suddenly popped in. Oh my goodness. I apologise. I'm guessing someone who's actually watched this all the way through, and I bet it's only going to be one person. It's going to start going, hey, you missed that thing over there. Why did you walk past it 3 times? Oh, goodness me. Yes, I have noticed the views have been a bit short of late. Everyone loves the first video in a series and then never bothers watching the next one. Window. Can I just clip into those? Yes, I can. Oh dear. Well, it glows. You think I could use it, but all right, back down here again. I'm just gonna follow the lights on the roof. This door here. What am I doing? This is absurd. Oh, I'll rejoin you in a minute. I think I found it. This really unobvious thing. Yeah, that's the way out. Why didn't they have it at the end of the long corridor?
Is excruciating decay hell?
Imagine a condition where you feel very bad morally, and there's nobody around who could offer a helping hand, and there's no glimpse of hope, and such a rainy day will never be succeeded, replaced with the sunny one. You want to leave a room, but there's not even a door. You jump towards the window, but it turns into a wall. There's no opportunity to do anything, to change something. There's no logic behind what's happening. It's impossible to stop these tortures with death, because it just does not exist. It has nothing in common with fear. Just a horrible feeling of dread.
Depression, basically. Anxiety as well. We've got music, we've got blackness.
Do we inhabit the world of wishes and thoughts between reincarnations?
That's right.
So you're saying we live in dreams before we're reincarnated? All this reincarnation nonsense is annoying me. Reincarnation would be cool, kind of. But my biggest gripe is you don't remember anything from your past lives, so there's no real way of improvement. It all comes down to fluke. It means hard to improve if you're living in somewhere like really boring. I'm back where I started. Except the floor's dry. That's nice. Go to the forest. Hello?
I met a central elemental one.
Oh no.
I met essential elemental ones on the way to you. They were talking about the worlds that they filled in.
Even meaningless motions of your hand take place in space. The same holds for the rest of the universe. Everything got its place, or a world, including our wishes and thoughts.
They were talking to me about a thin world and the fiery world.
There are many phases of universal material, by analogy with water that can be either as a liquid or as a piece of solid ice, or even as a gas like steam. The highest state, or the highest world, is referred to as the divine. In the absence of better title, then there is a rougher state called monadic. These two worlds are inaccessible for human understanding. Something is known about the following worlds, called the spirit world, and the intuitive world. The fifth and the sixth worlds are already accessible to humans, and they are called the fiery world and the subtle world. The final seventh, and the roughest sphere, is called the dense world. This is our physical world visible with eyes.
Does it mean that our thoughts and wishes exist in reality as well, since they are all worlds?
The thought is immaterial.
Inside the world of wishes?
It's a fantastic graveyard of human emotions.
Okay, that's a good way to describe
it. What about dreams?
It's not hard to guess based on what's been just told.
What is going to be further after that?
What is supposed to be? A young spirit, who has recently left the animal state, is unable to control his passions, his rough nature, only his ego, and never keeps quiet and persistent. I want exist from him. A human realizes there's another direction. Let me help you, after he develops further. Then the collective good becomes the main note of living. Boundless creative development is further ahead. And after the human stage, and after the superhuman stage, and further on, there's no end. Borderless. The whole universe is open. Only your free will determines whether you're okay to go forward or not. Now, Mr. Harvey, you're approaching the place where the architect is.
Let's get out of here before the song. Finally, please. I'm not even going to bother talking to him. He's just going to play a little guitar riff for like a minute. Unless he is the architect. The guy at the beginning was the architect all along. Wouldn't be the first time he's done that. In a game. That is a is that supposed to be leather, or what is that material? I keep looking at it and thinking, that looks horrible. Or plastic.
Hi.
How are you? I am the architect.
So it was you who envisioned everything here?
I envisioned the decorations only, and filled them with the narrative. For you. Essentially, I'm just a traveler like you.
I came for the award.
I express my hope that you understand the award has been received already.
My journey here was the award.
Knowledge is a precious award. It's possible to understand and do everything when one possesses knowledge. You won't get sucked into an ooze of delusion, stagnation, and slavery. It will be only you who will determine your way. The water has dried up in your apartment. Feel free to go home, Mr. Harvey.
Is everything that you've told me the truth?
The heart is faster than the mind. It will give you an answer.
So, apparently, yes? No? Well, thank you for wasting my time. And also, knowledge is powerful, yes. That is fish. But it doesn't stop horrible things from happening to you. It can just help you get out of a situation. Yes, so that was the, the playthrough of fish. Sorry, I just lost it there. This has melted my brain. It really has. It's weird. I don't know if I'd describe it as wonderful. But it was a journey. And thank you for joining me for it. And listening to me ramble on in frustration at it. Again, link is in the description for anyone to explore this or break it or speedrun it. Got those if someone wants to speedrun it. I could send this to Easy Speedies. You might want to speedrun it. I'll catch you next time.